All right. I think we are live. Decided to throw in an extra stream, or at least a pre-weekend stream. See if anyone's awake, or if it's just me who can't sleep tonight. Why don't we get the game rolling? Hopefully people will join. If you're watching this after the fact, as always, please do fast forward to wherever. Hi, Radu. How are you tonight? Let's take a look at the teams. Been a lot of Rage Force played lately. Dr. Cosmonaut as the Burgundians in yellow, in his pocket the Persians in orange by Chaos. Sensar in gray as the Hindustanis, and last but not least, Cool Cat the Aztec in red. So the Aztec is facing off against who? Menunez as the Ethiopian. Okay, two good infantry civilizations. Dratic as the Goth. It's going to be painful. Valis as the Koreans in green, and rounding out, Samero as the Bulgarians. So Bulgarians against Burgundians. You also can't sleep. So Bulgarians, Burgundians, that'll be an interesting matchup. Let's take a look at the map. It looks like one avenue of attack to the north. Bit of an X-Men shaped forest path here, and then a big open space. Big between our Aztec and our Ethiopian. Let's see those Shotels taking on some kind of Aztec Garland Wars upgraded infantry. Always like to see those heavy hitters. Oh, you said that in French? Okay. I have not spoken or read or anything French in like, let me do the math. I want to say like 25 years. And by the way, because this is a kind of a middle of the week stream, it's probably going to be one or two games, so not the longest stream in the world. But I figured, you know what? Been a good day. Might as well go live and see if anyone else is awake. So far, I see two. Let's see. Our Valis, our Korean in green, is moving out. No one's making any attempt to wall any of this, which is very interesting. Not a lot of villager action so far. I mean, this is going to be a nightmare for everybody. This is either one very long wall off, another very long wall off, or they're just going to have to treat this like Arabia. To the north. Yeah. So this might be one of the most peaceful maps. Yeah, this really might be one of the most peaceful maps we've ever seen. Maybe the most pacifistic start. Oh, look at this. Look at this. I love these shenanigans already. Build a gate. Now he can't repair his palisades. Okay, so I said there was peace, and of course, immediately war breaks out. And just bear with me, I'm just going to check my Reddit to make sure I set up my notifications properly. And you know, look at that, I did. Very interesting. Usually, Cast of Empires and technology don't really go hand in hand. Hi, Gray Shrimp. What time is it in California? Ooh, I wish I knew. I wish I was in Los Angeles right now. I'm stuck here in Toronto, where it is 10:50 p.m. And tomorrow we're expecting 5 to 10 centimeters of snow. In case you're wondering why I would rather be in L.A. in Santa Monica on that ridiculous beach. I mean, these players are now committing. I'm surprised, but lesson learned, a cautionary tale for everybody. Not to leave one little part sticking out, lest your opponent build that gate. And then all of a sudden, what was an idyllic situation, two peaceful communities living side by side, not only in the alphabet, but on the map as well, now have erupted into war. In the center, purple is, okay, walling that off. Our Aztec has managed to get his scout in here. So there'll be action here to the north. Uradu, I wish you the best of luck. The fights sounds are therapeutic. Yeah, that's why I prefer to have the, I know some casters like to have the villagers with the boxing gloves. I like it when they whip out their swords and they start attacking each other. Okay, decides to back away. And look at that, it is Menunez. Surprising, not usually a flank who hits the next age first. Usually a nice secure pocket that doesn't have to deal with any kind of shenanigans, but how sour is this? You queue up to play some Rage Forest. You wait, you wait, you wait for everyone's internet to kick in. And then you basically spawn Arabia. Or Arena, maybe even. That's pretty funny. Three boars to the top, three boars here, three snow leopards. Actually, four. It's being taken by our Bulgarian. Let's see what's going on here. he's just strolling in and out of Yellow's little gate here. Chaos is pulling three boars. One down, two down, three down. Remember, in this new version... not version. In this latest patch, you can't do that house foundation trick where you build a house underneath the boar and then all of a sudden they magically forget where they are and they just kind of stumble around. Oh, nice. The Aztecs. Did you play the Aztecs? I'm going around with my mouse. It's helping me like an old man pointing a finger at a book to see where there are units. Very, very, very risky, Scout. Why? I mean, this is another strange thing we've never seen here. A Hindustani creating a wall off made out of his military. Okay. Where does this one villager keep going back and forth, or is it just me? I feel like we've been seeing one villager move back and forth between these yellow palisades for the last 5 or 6 minutes. Let's see it. Look at that. Look at our Hindustani being a real pal. I think Blue's gonna screw himself here. What if he's not careful? Oh, if he's not paying attention! Okay, he is paying attention. That was almost very, very sour, but he manages to jail Teal's, oh my goodness, jail Gray's scout behind there as well. Is he gonna have to delete one of those palisades? We'll see. Okay, villagers move back. Not too sure why the boar stopped. Oh, because the, I guess the villager garrison. And down he goes. Okay, our Aztec, not surprising, the most military out on the map, but there's already a tower here by Menunez. To the north, are we going to see another red villager walking here? No, we don't. Yellow walls. Teal walls. Everyone's walling. We're at that stage of the game as we approach the 20-ish, 20 to 30, when the walls start becoming a little less relevant. As mangonels and stuff like that pops out. But for now, pretty damn relevant. Our Ethiopian, nice and secure behind a pretty thick wall off here. And he's making it even thicker with a whole bunch of feudal age structures that he needs to go up to the next stage. Although, he does already have an archery range. No, no, no risk of shortage of lumber on this map. Tenshi, hello, hello. Tenshi, I need you to comment more. You come, you say hello. But let's hear your thoughts on some of these, games. Snow leopard, you've got loom. What are you running away for? Purple, yellow. So no one has yet laid. I mean, no, literally no one's claiming this gold. Yellow to the north, orange to the west, purple to the east. Somebody's gonna have to take this gold at some point. Our Asta continues with the futility of attacking an outpost. But such is life in Age of Empires. Okay, red villagers are now moving forward. Okay. I'm glad they both lost like 10 villagers apiece here 10 minutes ago. just so they could carve up the map exactly where they both kind of really but not really wanted to. I mean, yellow would have wanted it here, which would have potentially jeopardized the gold. But yeah, as always, fun to laugh at early Rage Forest. Ooh. Oh, you are on your own, Gray Scouts, says Blue. Let's see the HPs. Okay, nah, Gray's done. I thought maybe his three scouts would have a little bit more HP than the four in there, you know, could survive a little bit longer, but nah. Radu, which one? Oh, damn, it's John Yang. And Martin as well. Thank you so much, Martin. I appreciate that comment. Scout mosh pit. Yeah, welcome, everyone. I figured I'd go live one day before tomorrow's live stream as well. Why the hell not? It's been a long day. I figured let's end it with a game or two of Age of Empires. May not be the longest of streams. May not last 2 hours, but I figured I want to have some fun at the end of this day. Can't really sleep, so here we are. Idle Villager is luckily passed out in his crib. Thank you for asking. And yeah, hopefully he stays idle until 7 a.m. And then he can wake up and, you know, whatever the hell babies do. Yeah, they're pushing the boulder up and down the slope. Not really getting much, but here we go. Like I said, 20 to 30 minute mark. Now wall offs all of a sudden become a little less relevant. And then at around the 30 plus minute mark, wall offs mean literally nothing. This map, enclosed off as it is, becomes Arabia. Onagers basically have their way. And I don't think we have a Khmer. No, no Khmer, so no Ballista Elephants, so we have to wait till Imperial to start cutting through forests. Yeah, exactly, who needs sleep? Have they busted in through this yet? No, okay, Manganel's definitely gonna help that. I like the Aztec healing up his teammate. So a little bit of confusion reigning here at Blue's Wall off initially, but seems like him and Gray are working quite well together here to the south. Speaking of working well together, our Korean is here with his Mangonel. He is heading up to Imperial, by the way. That is a fast Imperial. Holy shit. For Valus. This is what happens when Valus plays pocket. This is exactly what happens when Valus plays pocket. He hits Imperial at the 22 minute mark, and now he's going to have 10 range Mangonels. That being said, that it's expensive to upgrade them that well, that much. So let's see what he actually has. Nah, he can't do that on the back of 36 villagers. So he's gonna have to focus on his economy for a little bit if he wants to get his Mangonels up to Onagers, Onagers up to Siege, Siege up to 10 range. Castle for our Ethiopian. Sleep is option. Option. Oh, Jesus. Order pizza? I don't know. Yeah, John's suggestion is probably the best. Lay down. Uh-oh. I talked a big game about synergy, but out pop a bunch of Gothic light cavalry units. And thus ends the Aztec Hindustani push. Let's see what our Ethiopian has behind this castle, Mangonel. Oh, let's see some torsion engines out of our Ethiopian. Let's see him, like, kill 30 units at once. Valus, very aggressive forward castle, but oh, can only spare two villagers. This is what I'm talking about. When you cut corners, instead of having... I say cut corners like a bad thing. I don't mean it as in a bad way. Rush up to the next age. Instead of having 8 villagers build a castle, you've got 2. Your fishing industry isn't that the greatest, but 21 is not bad. Well, let's take a look at, yeah, Valus's resources. He needs a lot more gold. Ooh, Martin. I'm not too sure the exact Elos, but the games that I cast, generally, unless I point it out or unless we know of one player in particular, they're usually anywhere from 1800, like high 1700s maybe, to, you know, the Viper and Hera and Mr. Yo. Somebody like Valus, I think, is in the low 2000s. And then everyone else, I think, Dr. Cosmonaut might be even more than that. Valus might be more than that, actually. They might be like 2400s. Ah! Manganel gets a lucky shot off. Lucky because Cool Cat's not paying attention, but uh-oh. Uh-oh. Here we go. It didn't have to wait. Didn't even have to wait until the 30-minute mark for this map to become Arabia. A Bulgarian-Korean push. Ugh, that must be so gross to defend against. Can you imagine the static defense and static offense that's going to come with this push? Towers, creposts. Ugh, it pains me to even think about it. I should join Memb on his Rage Forest team. I didn't know he had a Rage Forest team. I know he loves playing Rage Forest. Ah! All of this is a waste of time. It's all a waste of time. You can't wall off at this stage of the game. Oh! These Manganels are just getting amazing hits, both into the north, to the north and to the south. John, thanks for stopping by. Yeah, hopefully he can catch you tomorrow. Maybe Stanley Camels are out. Richard, you are not late. We are not too far into the first game. Conics are absolutely shredding this. I wanted to see some stats. Okay, here we go. More creposts, more creposts. And now these are siege onagers. So it actually didn't take Valus. Okay, no, never mind. He skipped on the range upgrades. So it took him a good amount of time to get these upgrades. Ooh, that is very sour to have to lose yours. Remember, Korean Manganel line comes with one minimum range. So that's how he got those two Cavaliers and oh, that's so sour right before he falls. Hindustani adding some archery ranges. Let's see some Shatagni hand cannoneers. Grand Trunk Road is going to help his teammate. Tenchi, it's GG. Really? You think so? So soon? Let's see. Our Persian. I wanted to click the camel. Of course, I clicked the wall. Plus two, plus two. Not everyone is an Imperial, actually. Valus is the only one on his team. But the Persian and the Hindustani, they are both an Imperial. So let's see what that looks like. Yellow, has he run away with any villagers? Yes, he has. Cosmonaut has more than enough wood to build three town centers. What is he waiting for? Does he think he can save his base? Look at him, he's just mining gold. Not a care in the world. Converting individual conics who dismount. Ooh, Radu, I'm gonna leave that to the chat to answer. Our Persian is inadvertently keeping the gate open, but doesn't really matter because it's open here anyway. 29 heavies now. Let's see what Teal is up to. Not much down here yet. And here we go. I wonder how a Persian camel is going to do against the conic. The conic itself should die fairly quickly. But then it dismounted. Three melee armor is not good. That is not a good stat. And I think the dismounted conic hits pretty much just as hard as the mounted. Oh, he loses one to a conversion. But Valus isn't even giving him the chance. He's trying to kill these camels. Here we go. We're about to find out. Either way, Orange is winning this fight, right? Just numbers-wise. Yeah, they attack the same as a mounted conic, a base of a 12. Except the camels don't do bonus damage against them, so... Where the hell are you going? Where are you going? The biggest loser in that battle, Valus, with all of his monks and mangonels. And now we've got Savars. Tenchi, I think they do against camels, because camels come with that bonus against cavalry, so the mounted guy dies. They come with a plus 18 attack. There it is, cavalry, plus 18. But when they're dismounted, they have no bonus, but the numbers here are Persian is mopping up the floor here. Oh, Radu, no, after this, I am definitely going to sleep. I appreciate it, though, but no, not tonight. Yeah, no, camels are basically like a purpose-built unit to destroy cavalry. Everything else, they pretty much, I don't want to say they suck at it, because they're like, they're still a decent unit, and some of them come with cool features. Hindustanis attack faster, Saracens, their camels have like 170 HP, which is freaking ridiculous. Hindustanis, by the way, like we're seeing here, are going to have Imperial camels in a minute. So they're decent units. They're not great, though. I mean, look at the stats. They attack on like a longbow. This is the 7 of a longbow, of an archer unit. Now that they're Imperial, attack on an 8. It's not great. Really is one of these units that you really care about the bonuses. They're camel 9, cavalry 18. Our Persian is just absolutely single-handedly saving our Burgundian. Although our Burgundian, you know what, has mixed in 14 monks. So woe unto anyone who tries to throw any kind of units this way. They are going to get converted. And that's how he has 25 army supply. Look, he's got more conics. He's got more conics than the Bulgarian. Our Burgundian. That's hilarious. I love when stuff like that happens. Oh, I don't think you should be smoking more. Here we go. This is what I was talking about. Goths in the pocket, lining up. What are they, on parade? How about you go and help out? At this point, our Goth, the name of the game is just spam, spam, spam. Trade out your army 10 times. Well, I'm not sure why he went. Why did he go halberdier? Dratek. Was he really expecting that many camels? I mean, hand cannoneers are still archer units, so... Huskarls are going to absolutely wreck them if they can close. Is he training Huskarls? He's got 20 of them. Where are they? Where are they coming from? Oh, there are barracks here. Okay. So he is starting to add in more and more. Okay, our Bulgarian, having failed with the blunt force trauma approach, is now going death from afar with his cav archers going up to 26 of them. And now Valus has finally gotten the Siege Onager to its most dangerous. This is an Apex Predator. 10 range on a Siege Onager. In the hands of a player like Valus, Orange is going to have to pull some real fancy. He's going to have to be like John Travolta in Saturday Night Fever. Apologies for anyone who doesn't know that, understand that reference. I'm not sure I don't. That movie is even before my time. He's going to have to be light on his feet, let's put it like that. Otherwise, he's going to just take an absolute pounding to the face. Yeah, our Goth needs to trade out this army. And he needs to stop building halberdiers. What's his... I mean, you've got 2,500 gold. Where'd you just spend 1,000 of it? Just spent 1,000 of his gold. Maybe bought something? I like that he's adding barracks here too. I love this out of purple, but oh no, is he queuing them? Okay, he is queuing them to the front here. Trebs are missing the onagers. The onagers need to move a little quicker here. Uh-oh, orange. A few monks get caught in the crossfire. Valis definitely needs a lot more than 5 or 6 onagers. Our Persian is raining death from afar here. Raul Vega, hello, hello. Very Ethiopian. We got a few gold miners thrown into the mix. He's got 1500 stone. He's gonna drop 3 castles, 2.5 castles on top of his opponent's head. And look at that attack speed on an arbalest. Ugh, Mangadai speed. Oh, but wait a second. The Aztec prioritizing villagers. I love it. I love it. Yikes. Bulgarian heavy cav archers. Where are Valis's onagers? He only has these two here for now. So stalemate, yellow has recovered fantastically. And now he's starting to add in Burgundian gunpowder. Remember, they attack 25% more. I never understood why the Burgundians got that and not the Bohemians. And I know I'm a broken record, and I know I'm a broken record for always saying I'm a broken record. Oop, my mouse, my microphone, sorry. Shuatang, hello, hello. How are you? This morning for you. Where the... Oh, never mind. What's the game plan for the castle? Okay, he's bringing one treb here. What's inside of this? Oh, just one treb. Our Burgundian needs to get into this a little bit more. Where are his hand cannoneers? Okay, so they're standing across the lake, dealing their 21 damage. That's freaking Janissary level damage. Valis's entire army supply is halberdiers. Our Goth's entire army supply is halberdiers. I don't get it. You're facing off against hand cannoneers and jaguars, both of which have attack bonuses against infantry. Decent attack round there out of the bombards, but now they've got to retreat. Oh, beautiful walling off here. Beautiful walling off. And with that walling off, you should be able to save these bombard cannons. That was gorgeous. And here we go, Huskarls. You're not taking me down with 10 pierce armor, he says, as he gets taken down by that archer unit. Yes, I had some carrots today. Rabbit. That's funny. I haven't broken any records yet. Oh, you're from Brazil. I think, yeah, Raul, I think you told us that before. And I think I told you the story of how I wanted to learn surfing in Brazil, but my flight got messed up and I never ended up going. Ooh, and here we go. Finally, the Huskarls. Forget your silly halberdiers, but you're taking on jaguars. Tenchi, you like that wall off? So the infantry push continues. What is our Hindustani doing, by the way? Having researched Imperial camels. Sensar has 51 on gold, 52 on food. And he's going hussars. Okay. Our Ethiopian almost has no army whatsoever. So there's going to be a stalemate here for a little bit. As there is here. The funny thing is, here there is a stalemate because no one has any army. Here there's a stalemate because everyone has too big of an army and they can't really engage into one another. Radu, that's not a low elo thing. I think that's a common sense thing. Everyone does that, no? Mix in some good old trash unit. Oh, pancake. That is literally half of the Burgundian army that just melted, and somebody is finally pinging this gold saying, hey guys, why the hell is no one taking that gold? And let's see it, Huskarls taking on Jaguars. We know who wins that battle, but the Jaguars have to get to them first through a hail, a absolute storm of arrows from these machine gunners. Look at how fast this unit attacks. But holy shit. Cool cat. Maybe went a little overboard. Even Huskarls are gonna struggle against four castles, but what won't struggle is three trebuchets. Yeah, Blue's gotta come up with some kind of game plan to deal with these trebs. And Gray has to come and help out. I don't know that hand cannoneers are really gonna be the thing to do it. They're just way too slow. And yeah, okay, look at this nice symmetrical box. Yeah, it's a lot of castles. And unless I'm wrong, that's it for yellow. No more castles for you. Man, our Persian is so hesitant to engage into this. Look at the armor on a Savar, 6-8. Oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no. Oh, why did that have to happen behind a freaking archery range so we couldn't see it? That was disgusting. 81 kills, but look at the friendly fire, 23. That is not a great ratio. But that was absolutely epic. Why did we not get to see that? Two of the four castles are down. Our Hindustani has finally brought some trebs of his own. 16 plus 1 versus 16 range. And he's instead targeting the castle of the Ethiopian and not the trebs of the Goth. Oh, look at this. Ah, sacrifices his own two mangonels. I'm looking at army supply, and yeah, now it's GG. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Yikes. That was a bloody, bloody game. I'm really upset that the two biggest mangonel onager hits were behind an archery range, and that group of, where was it, like 15 hand cannoneers, the yellow, the Burgundian hand cannoneers. It was also like in between a bunch of structures. So the biggest hits were in these alleys, and that just made it hard for us to see. But that was absolutely epic. They end with how many kills? 74. So one of them did die. No, no Mihai this game. And wow. Okay. So stalemate down here, and here they're going to lose. There's nothing they can do. The Persian had the momentum for a little bit. Chaos to win, and then he couldn't do 2-1, even though he had a whole bunch of monks from our Burgundian to support him. Yeah, let's do one more game. Tenchi, you called it 20 minutes ago. You don't have to apologize, Ryder. It's all good. Martin, good night. Thanks for joining and chatting. Let's see who the teams are here. Yellow, blue, gray, and teal. What do we want to call this? Let's call them Team South. You can tell by the speed that I type that watching me play this game will be like, yeah. Let's see who's playing fresh to death. Okay. As the Celt in yellow in his pocket. Samero as the Japanese in blue. Sensar as the Burmese in gray. And very far away. Very far away. We've got Chaos to win this time as the Poles. The Poles, who are they taking on? The Malians. Uh-oh. Barimba Camels in red for Jam Jack. Menunez as the Mayans in orange, a good sift to have. All the walls 50% off. Dratek as the Bengali. Let's see some fatty elephant archers. And Valus as the Magyar. So what are we going to see? 100,000 cav archers out of Valus? Who is moving forward? Ooh, the HPs are going down at the exact same time. They're going down at the exact same time. What happens if their ping is the same? Ah, oh, they disengage. They disengage. Nah, oh, that's very sour. I asked in one of my videos a few days ago, what happens if two units attack each other at the exact same time? And somebody in the comments posted that it depends on the ping and whoever has the highest ping. I wonder if that's the fairest way to do it, or if it's I guess it makes sense that that's the technically the only way to do it, right? Because whoever hits first, and if your ones and zeros register at the server quicker, technically you did hit first. Yeah, I want to see Magyar Cav Archers too. Magyar Cav Archers are pretty bonkers. Valus. One wall off, two wall off. So let's say I forgot to see who's facing off against who, except to the south. Magyars and Celts. You've got the siege civilization. You've got the Magyar Hussar, whose attack bonus is against siege. Let's see. Now I really want to see Magyar Hussars out of our Magyar. And Valus might actually... Valus always down for quantity and quality. Chaos's villager just wants to wall this off, but the Mayan won't let him. Oh! Closed in with him. Okay. So our pole really doesn't want to lose this villager. Really does not want to lose this villager. Why are you contesting this? It's not a bad wall off. You've already let him move very forward here. Who cares about this then? Jam Jack making an issue of it, but our Burmese has brought an allied scout, but the eagle is still here. So two scouts, two eagles, but look at the difference in HP. Oh no, oh no, oh no, he's not paying attention. He took literally four pokes. Now the HP is a lot closer, and oh! Shot it. That was a very weird, sour turn of events. Richard, thanks for joining. Have a fantastic rest of your day. Tenchi, North will win. Okay, interesting. So you like Val, your team Valus all the way. Who unfortunately is being left on his own. Purple not really helping him out. Dratic, our Bengali. Bye. Fall off successful. This way in here, why not just across? Maybe that's what he thought initially, but he wanted access to the water in case he needed to lame a dock or something. So a good move, actually, out of Valus, if that's the logic. Because a shorter wall off with the house already here would have been diagonal, but that would have lost him control. Or lost him access, let's say. Now he's got beach rights. He can build a condo here and park his villager. Okay, at the end of the day, Teal gets his wall off where he wants. Red's villager is trapped. Two HP. Ooh, okay, you know what we're about to see here. Radu is also Team North. As Samero, our Japanese, pulls his three boars. Oh, I thought it was a three boar pull. Instead, it's three villagers killing a wolf. Okay, Valus is basically being left to wall everything off on his own, which is good and bad. I mean, how do you even begin to defend this? This is like, I like the lumber camp here kind of in the center between these two, But then you've got this. What do you build another lumber camp? Now you have to spend another 100 wood? I guess the answer is no. I guess you let purple handle that over there. Oh, that trick. Wait a second. That trick's not supposed to work anymore. Oh, no, no. It does work, but they return. Oh, okay, right. Sorry, I confused. I confused the feature. You can still build a house underneath a boar. It'll stun them. They'll stop chasing you, but then they actually return back to their ancestral hunting grounds, which this one, so he didn't build a house under these two. So they just kind of went back, but they got stuck. This one is actively trying to return. So this boar is actually going to go on an insane journey right now. And I don't think he can even make it because he's going to run into a wall off. This might be a good idea for like a Disney movie. Like he makes some friends along the way. They spend have a few adventures together, but then ultimately it comes time for these two hobos. The what was the name of that old TV show with the littlest hobo to part ways. I really do want to keep an eye on this boar. I want to see where the hell he goes. He's got nowhere to go. Unless by some miracle, Valis opens up this gate right now to maybe let the villager through. No, he's doubling down on the wall off. And now he's heading back. Okay, we'll stop paying attention. I'm going to keep the mouse on the boar. As our Malian pushes in, our pole wants nothing to do with this. Oh no. Villager down. And now the scout is trying to keep the boars here while this villager, where are you going? Now you're trying over here. Man, the coding in the game is so much fun. I don't know where, now there's two boars trying to get back home. This is amazing. Look at this. So this is going to be like, you know, those oceanic currents, like in the Atlantic and in the Pacific. Did he not take the other two? No, they went back. So those boars are going to be floating around the map like an oceanic current. Raul, the pleasure's all mine. At least he managed to get the one boar. Yeah, they're just going to keep floating around. Oh, Age of Empires doing Age of Empires things. Not zero risk of that going down. Valis still has scouts on the other side of the map. Of course he does. He can un-garrison them. Yellow might want to just wall around this to make sure units can't pop out on that side. But our Malian is really pushing in here. He's got an aggressive dock. And was I right about Valis? No, never mind. I wanted to see if he put up a dock here, but that may be beyond the capabilities of our Magyar. He would need about 5 times the wood income for that. Yeah, Radu, I'm very happy about that. I am very happy about that. Yeah, very threatening. So threatening, even one villager is enough to stop them. 1470, 1460, 1450. Yeah, so it's going to take about 3 minutes for this to go down. Oh, damn. 7K. Let's see it. Our Mayan has joined in. Oh, look at how lucky that is. I was wondering, I was looking at the mini map. Look at this area on the mini map. It looks like it's completely enclosed off. And then you zoom in, and how lucky is this? That is very lucky for our Mayan, who now has access to the lake. 3 boars, gold, stone, anything and everything, which is no surprise why he's plopped down the first castle here, going those adorably powerful plumes. Okay, this is going to be way too much for one villager to repair. So he knows that, backs away, creates 3 wall-offs, structures, stone, and stone. because he sees the Siege Workshop here, and the last thing you want to do with Celtic Siege is take it for granted, underestimate it. Yeah, it's definitely a blessed map generation for our Mayan, who looks like he is... Okay, I thought he was taking boars. No, he is attacking a wolf. This is potentially very problematic here for purple and green. Valis has no army. Purple has no army except for one monk. And this is a sizable group of units here. This is light cavalry. They're not scouts anymore. These are light cavalry units. They're faster. They're stronger. Their line of sight is better. They can see a lot more and kill a lot quicker. Oh, no Britons in this one. I always want to see Britons with the longbows in Rage Forest. Vizbot, hello, hello. Vizbot, you were the one who told me about the when two units attack each other, it depends on the ping, right? That was your comment. Right? I think. Let me know if I sound crazy. Another Mayan castle being dropped here. Oh, I love seeing plumed archers. Yeah, that was you, right? Okay. Corey, hello, hello. What's the best Rage Forest sim? Ooh. I mean, we saw Valis put on quite a clinic with 10 range Korean siege onagers. I'm not too sure what the best Rage Forest Civ is. Definitely a few factors that are important, including having the best siege. So if you don't have a good siege line, you are out of the running. I'm trying to click on the boars. Did he not get wild boar, wild boar? Okay, he got both of them. Oh, and this is what happens when light cav enter your base, but they're not moving. They're stuck. They're derping out. Push here continues. I don't know why he's stopping to, why these units leave this to the Rams. You go and attack. You go and kill, kill, kill. Otherwise, Valis, our Magyar, is going to have these. Oh, the Knights pull a few fancy maneuvers. They're going after the Mangonel, but he knows. He knows he can't get that Mangonel without losing those Knights. I don't think he could even get that Mangonel, to be honest. Ugh, now our Mayan is in trouble. This is why I said it was bad news, this thing. Yeah, they didn't have enough army. Usually when a player tries to bust in early, I don't understand it. When your entire army is one Mangonel, why are you trying to bust into your opponent's base? But yellow and blue had a sizable force there. Look at this emergency wall off. He is just being pushed further and further back. Let's see what resources he's lost control of. He's lost control of the primary stone. Secondary gold, kind of mineable. Not really. Primary gold, secondary, tertiary is nice and safe. Okay, so not terrible. Not terrible for our pull. Oh, Jesus. I mean, what's Valis doing to defend against this? He's going knights. What's purple doing? Purple's going one militia, man. Our Bengali is throwing in militia. What are his resources like? I mean, the saving grace to the north is that to the south, chaos to win is still in feudal age. And he is nowhere close to going up to castle. So they've got an ability here. Demos, demos, demos. They've got an opportunity here to, if they can push in hard enough, to make sure Teal never really gets into the game, even if he gets up to castle age, to make sure that his villager count, his economy is crippled so much. He's literally got one town center, and that's all. On the other hand, they need to stop this, and it kind of looks like they have. Okay. Tenshi, your prediction, Team North. So so far looking pretty accurate. Oh, I love that he still has this one militia. Yeah, Teal is being given a lot of leeway. He feels comfortable enough. He's building a third dock behind enemy lines right now. If they knew how little Teal had outside of this area, I think they would be pushing this town center. They see it with the castle's vision. And now what are they doing? They're attacking a wall. Why not the blacksmith? Why not... Okay, I guess he agrees. Who's heading up to Imperial? We've got our Burmese heading up to Imperial. Our Japanese heading up. So the two pockets. No big surprise there. Valis, our Magyar, is heading up to Imperial. He's getting Thumring. He's getting Bodkin. So my wish of seeing Magyar Hussars seems like it is going to take the back seat to Cav Archers. No, it does not look good for the Poles at all. Our Pole needs to get a second town. I don't understand why he's not building a second town center. Does he think he can hold this? He had the wood a second ago. Now he doesn't. He's got the stone, which is the more important thing, having lost control of the primary stone here. But even, like I said, even if he gets up to castle, which he now is, he's just economically so far behind. Look at his villager count, 57. Second lowest in the game after Valis. Rather, lowest in the game, actually. Sorry. Our Magyar collecting relics. Let's see. Our Burmese planning a halberdier surprise. Their halberdiers pack a freaking punch. Oh, sorry, what am I talking about? The Japanese. Did I say Burmese? I think I said Burmese. The Japanese. They attack 33% faster at 2.3 second delay, which is just redonkulous. Does make a huge difference. And Teal. Teal says, this land is my land. Demolition raft. Thicker fire galley are going to be, fire ship are going to be greeting him in a second. Very important for him to get rid of this one before it upgrades. And Red Armalian is obliging. No, he's just, oh my god, he's just drawing Teal into arrow fire. Look at this gameplay, and now he's probably going to repair it. This is incredible out of Armalian. Does lose one of the docks that he has, but yeah, now it's upgraded. And everyone is heading up to Imperial, it looks like. Yasima Towers for our Korean. How much Japanese? My goodness. 183. Stone. And he is starting with a very defensive pair of towers here, expecting a push, expecting perhaps to lose his barracks. But now the game is going to get fun. 29 plumed archers, where are you? Why did it take me all the way here? This is hilarious. This is what happens when you're Mayans and your walls are 50% cheaper. Forget houses, forget palisades. Town center, will he try to pull the boar? I mean, it's 1,000 food for free. It's faster than my farming. Red has gotten 3 docks of his own up. Here are the plumed archers. Our Burmese with that ridiculous, what is he in, Imperial, plus 3 attack for free on those units. Now plus 5 with iron casting is here to defend the pole. Actually, you know what? Look at our pole all of a sudden. 1 extra town center, 2, 3 extra town centers. Those full works are ridiculous. But no Schlachta anytime soon. And yep, there we go. Valis on parade march. Pure Celtica. Siege onagers, siege engineers. Mahayana for the other side. Siege engineers as well. Heavy cav archer. Ooh, we are settling in for some big freaking battles, I think. Oh, sour loss there. Those trebs. That's so annoying. Ah. Remember the Japanese trebs fire. What is it? 25% faster? Oh no, sorry, he doesn't have Cataparuto yet. Okay. Never mind. I believe it fires on an 8-second delay instead of a 10-second delay, which adds up if your opponent sticks around. And down go the Malian docks, down go the castles. And all of a sudden, our Malian, the letter M, is very exposed. And what the hell is this? He wants to wall off the wall off. Make sure there can be no counterattack without first having to take down walls. Japanese infantry, they would love to close in on these Magyar cav archers, which are just baiting him so that the ones on the flanks can have their way with them. Siege onager as well for our Celt. Look at that, 100 HP on a siege onager. Did he try to kill his own ram there? What the hell is that? Want to kill that tree? Right now the Japanese basically just throwing these units away so that Valus doesn't focus on the trebs, giving Valus a few easy kills. It's like at a carnival where when you try, you know, they show you, hey, come try this game, and you try it and you win, and then you actually pay to play it, and then all of a sudden you can't win for shit. Cutting through the forest is our Burmese, who now comes under attack by the Malian gunpowder. 4 bombard cannons to 1 treb. Down goes the Burmese bombard cannon. Yeah, let's see. I figured. Let's see some nice choke point action here. Our Bengali. What is our Bengali doing, by the way? Halberdiers, Corvinian army. Oh, Valus is getting smushed here, though. Yeah, Corvinian army. Let's see those. He's got one castle. Let's see Magyar Hussars up the wazoo. Like I said, their attack bonus is against siege. They can be a pretty powerful unit against the Celts, as long as you can get rid of this meat shield. And that is what the cav archers are for. El Dorado as well. We're going to get to see 100 HP eagles. How many does he have? Not a single eagle warrior. How many barracks does Orange have? I don't see a single barracks here. He's got 1 barracks. Okay. So expect to see some construction out of Orange. As these Burmese battle elephants with their ridiculous armor move in. Man, our Malian is building up a pretty powerful army here. I don't know that it can take on these elephants, but there's a castle as well. Oh, they are just killing all of these super expensive units. And now they're closing in on the hand cannoneers. Oh, probably the worst elephant to go up against for any kind of pierce attack. 9 armor. I mean, howdy. That is a ridiculous amount of armor for a freaking elephant. Ooh, look at these guys, cock of the walk over here. Not expecting to get killed by the elephant anytime soon. God, look at that beautiful Celtic death machine. 67 kills, 0 friendly fire. Have we met the siege onager god? Okay, now he's killing a few of his own. I mean, that is, I don't think I've ever seen that. 67 kills, 0 friendly fire. Valus has 11. Magyar Hussars, was I right about their attack bonus against siege? Yeah, plus 8. That's better than a Mangadai, by the way. This is a ridiculously powerful anti-siege unit. The problem is, it's still a trash unit. And yellow seems to have attack rounds figured out. Oh, but this is sour. He's losing way too many of his own units. That unit is basically a trash Lakitic legacy for our pull. Forget the Cavaliers. How many stables does he have? 11 stables are gonna pump out trash units with trample damage for days. Our Mayan. There we go. I told you to expect construction out of him. 6-8 barracks. Not too sure what's building those. Hand cannoneer does 17 damage, I believe. Unless it's Burgundian, then it does 21. Yeah, 17. Uh-oh, Valus, why is your army moving so slow? Oh no, our Celt just got rear-ended, and so did our Japanese. Eagles are streaming in, but they're taking on Yasuma Towers. So we'll see how well they do over there. In the meantime, 44 kills, only 2 friendly fire. Great ratios by Fresh Death. I don't think we've seen this player play before, but so far very impressed with his Onager micro. Oh no. Like shooting fish in a barrel. Oh, that's so gross. Oh, he just deletes them. Why the hell let Orange have the satisfaction? Looks like the Eagles have been cleaned up by these Yasuma Towers. How many kills do they have? 33 kills. Yikes. Magyar Hussars doing the last thing they want to do, which is take on Japanese Halberdiers. Another castle going up to the north for Val. So he's definitely doubling down on Magyar Hussars, especially as his gold supply dwindles. But at the same time, our Burmese is here with Hussars. Uh-oh. Fully upgraded Hussars. So we've actually got 3 battlefields. We've got the siege war to the north. We've got this penetration by our Burmese to the east. Nothing happening to the south. And then the Mayan incursion here. But look at how quickly they die, even with 100 HP. Wow, Yasuma Towers for the win here. Holy shit. I mean, they barely even got to their target. He's not going to get anything done. Wow, if you ever needed an example of Yasuma coming in clutch for the Japanese, there you go. Oh, this is so sour when all of the hand cannoneers focus on one unit. You've got 36 units. You should be attacking. I mean, this is like, in theory, if you have the micro, you should be attacking 5 or 6 units with this quantity, not 1 or 2. But that's just, nigh impossible. Another Magyar castle comes under attack. How many does he have now? He's going up to 10 Magyar Hussars. That's going to be much harder to get now that he's down to 1 castle. The Kinetic Legacy for these Winged Hussars, area of effect range 0.5 tiles. And cannoneers are holding their own. What is Red pinging over here? Yeah, he's seen Grace Hussars. They need to deal with this. But our pole? He's not giving them an opportunity. Winged Hussars. Red has enough of a meat shield here. His hand cannoneers, actually, maybe not. Winged Hussars, I think, are tankier than normal Hussars. No, but he decides to retreat. Stop streaming in one unit at a time. Get a clump, and oh no, Burmese Hussars over here. Plumed archers trying to get some infrastructure destroyed, but that's, you're not gonna really do much. Japanese trebs, do they have Cataperuto? No, they do not. Oh my god. Oh, this is painful to watch. 49, 50 villagers, 51 villagers. Oh, this is so painful. This is so painful, our Bengali. What is happening? Where is he focusing on? There's nothing happening in the front. Nothing happening to the south? Why is he not defending these villagers? 72! Sorry, I hit my mic again. I don't know what's going on with me tonight, hitting my mic. Okay. Something's killing these guys. I'm not too sure what. Maybe these halberdiers. Which our Bengali lost 72 villagers. That being said, look at Valus. His base is done. Look at the beautiful towers. 30. I'm going to zoom out ridiculous. Sorry, guys. 42 towers. The meaning of life. Yeah, it definitely seems like sabotage. How the hell do you lose 72 villagers and not react or do anything about it? Maybe he wanted to lose the villagers. Maybe he... I think I saw him... Oh no, Valus is done. That's it. It's over. Tenshi, you called it 2 for 2 tonight. No, no. What am I talking about? No, no. You called Team North. You're 1 for 2. That was just a beautiful siege push. Let's look at the stats at the end. 64 kills, 1 friendly fire. Wow. So I didn't mean to sound like Owen Wilson there. Wow. No, that's a really impressive number. Look at the damage dealt by these onagers. 9 onagers, 23,700, 24,000 resources. Oh my god, that is crazy. When only 1 friendly fire, which is probably one of their own onager lines, onager units, plumed archers. Oh my god, look at the stats difference. Trade non-existent. Both the biggest giver and the biggest receiver here is our Japanese in blue. Highest kill count for Valus, no surprise there. Any close? Look at that, only 7 away, our Japanese. And then 355 Burmese. This Burmese cut. Sorry, not this one. This one was absolutely epic. And then all of the infrastructure here. The absolute destruction of the Bengali economy. I mean, why the hell do you lose 74 villagers and not react? Wow. Well, that was a fun last game. I think I'm going to call it. Like I said, today is going to be a bit of a shorter stream, but definitely join tomorrow. And everyone, thank you so much for watching. Thank you for commenting. Thanks for chatting. Yeah, Kang, this is the last one for tonight. I'll be back tomorrow a little bit earlier than tonight, but yeah, bit of a shorter stream this one. Oh, definitely not Supreme Caster. Definitely not. But yeah, see everyone tomorrow. Tenshi, goodbye. Thanks for commenting and chatting with us. Thanks, Vizbot. Raul, thank you so much and have a wonderful day in Brazil. And hopefully see you as well tomorrow for more of, hopefully more of this. More of the, I mean, good for Fresh to Death. I don't know who this player is. But if they catch this live stream, we are very impressed with your Siege Onager Micro. Very impressed. But everyone, Radu, go lie down, take it easy. Everyone have a fantastic night, and I'll see you tomorrow.